And I think just sort of like first question is someone for like the perspective of like a film lover in Chicago, like, you know, you're familiar with like the Chicago International Film Festival, but you know, like what is there in the Cine Youth Festival to sort of bring film lovers together to see all of these youthful engaging voices?
Sure. Well, I mean, yeah, the central appeal of Cine Youth is that the filmmakers are all 22 years old and younger, and there's a huge portion of that program that come from Chicago. We have a lot of Chicago filmmakers represented all across, not only in the, we have a specific program, the Cinemas of Chicago program, but we also have Chicago filmmakers scattered amongst all the other films. But in general, to answer your question specifically about what Cine Youth, you know, sort of brings to the table, is you have all these young people that are sort of defining the future of cinema, and especially at a time when the state of cinema is a bit perplexing. It's really encouraging to see work from young filmmakers, especially from the past year, in a like rapidly changing art environment, creating new work, and how they've sort of tackled that directly. So in a sense, the draw for Cine Youth is not only watching filmmakers who are, you know, learning the ropes and sort of finding their own voice, they're also in a sense defining the future of cinema with their work. And that's, at least from my perspective, what's been the most exciting element and what it brings to the table for the Chicago film scene especially.
Yeah, and like having had positions like associate director and programmer, and now like this, essentially what it looks like from the outside is like you are running this festival. Is that fair to say?
Yeah, I've sort of been like a Swiss Army knife for the Chicago Film Festival for a while. I started back in 2014 when I was a student at DePaul as an intern, and I was helping out with archival material, and sort of that was in its 50th anniversary of the film festival, and we were creating a gallery to celebrate that. But then as the years have gone on, I've assisted with feature programming with a focus on the horror films. I also, as I said, I worked up in the projection booth managing that. And then, yeah, for the past technically 3 years, this is my second Cine Youth, but for the past 3 years, I've been the Cine Youth Festival Director. So I guess to get into that as well, too, you know, we had the program finalized last year, and then the pandemic sort of hit and shut everything down. And so what we decided to do was postpone Cine Youth, because at that point, it was initially supposed to be in May. We didn't know, naturally, everything was ever evolving. We didn't know what the next steps were. So we held off, and then our plan sort of changed. And what we did was we reopened submissions so a new batch of films could join the program. So this year, the 16th Cine Youth is a hybrid between films from 2020 and then new films that came in from 2021. So in that sense, it's also an interesting time capsule of how cinema has changed over the past 2 years and the different things people have been focusing on.
Yeah, and that's so, I didn't know that you guys like essentially like did like a hybrid between the years with that. And that's great, because, you know, it's that itself is a testament to, hey, this past year has just been tumultuous for everyone, and we get it. But with that, with those challenges, like come, you know, new voices, new engaging cinema to look at. And so you just kind of told me like, yes, there is something good that came out of that, but are there any like moments or anything that you can think of like I'm kind of like where you were glad that you were able to sort of make this work in a time when there were just massive hurdles every step of the way, and it was, like you said, ever developing?
Right. Yeah. So, you know, that was something we were really concerned about, because one of the central appeals of Cine Youth is that because the filmmakers are so young, the networking opportunities in person are extremely valuable. A lot of times it's filmmakers' very first film festival experience. And it sort of becomes, you know, there are some people who are a little bit established, maybe from film schools, but there's also plenty of high schoolers and even younger that sort of, you know, blind submitted, have never done anything like this before. So those in-person networking events are integral to Cine Youth. And that was, you know, something we were a little nervous about for the virtual format. But by committing to the virtual format, we've been able to do a lot more things we wouldn't have been able to do in the past. One of it being the program being so expanded, and having the films available globally. So now we're able to really connect all these global filmmakers with people from the States who, you know, these filmmakers that might not have been able to afford to fly all the way to Chicago. So in that sense, the community itself is growing much larger. And, you know, we still have networking events and panels that we might not have been able to do in person, that having those online certainly helps. But yeah, and I mean, it all proved to be worth it, especially once we reopened submissions and we're seeing the work that people have made within the past year under pandemic production circumstances. Because we do have a program of films where the filmmakers are tackling the pandemic head on, both from narrative and documentary perspectives. And that's certainly worth checking out to get to see, you know, how people have been managing.
Yeah, and there's just been just so much content created since the pandemic that, like, you essentially could look at it now and title it dated, but like, it's a time capsule. March of last year, we didn't know how long this was
absolutely
going to be, so on and so forth. And as like essentially like a curator of the Cine Youth content, there is a huge responsibility that comes with that in picking the quote unquote right content to show. And that it is a huge responsibility just when I was looking at it and thinking about it. But it's also like a great thing to be able to be like, okay, yeah, like I can sort of make these decisions. But what's that like process like for you? And how do you bear that responsibility of showing what you think deserves to be seen?
Sure. Well, I will point out that it is a collective effort. You know, I am the festival director, but I do have a programming committee. So it's a selection of this year. I think there were five other programmers on the team, and we all sort of comb through all the submissions. We write our reviews and we share them with each other. We discuss the films, having regular programming meetings. So in that sense, it's a really collaborative process, sort of deciding, you know, what is the most valuable work? What are we looking for? Especially in a time when social concerns are becoming, you know, extremely pronounced for the younger generation. And so much of the films are tackling all of that directly, not just the pandemic, but, you know, just the, you know, everything from the civil unrest in the United States to, you know, larger political issues. For example, we have like a program about climate change as well. Younger filmmakers are becoming more and more socially conscious. So because of that, then there's an extra weight on us to make sure that what we're representing is, you know, what the voices we're hearing, you know, from younger filmmakers. They're speaking to us and they're sort of guiding us on, you know, they're sort of instructing us in a sense on, you know, what's the word to get out to everyone else.
Yeah. And what I think is so great, especially with like younger and younger filmmakers, is like I feel like the word innovation is almost like a disservice, because when you come from nothing in terms of like, okay, you don't have film school, it's all of your imagination. You're coming up with these amazing ideas, and how can I present this idea in my head, and translating that to film at all is an accomplishment, you know?
Absolutely. And I mean, that what you're saying is exactly what we're looking for too. You know, sometimes when I talk to other students, and you know, they ask like, oh, what sort of things are you looking for? You know, what are film programmers looking for? And I always say, well, I'll tell you know what we're not looking for? We're not looking for the next Quentin Tarantino. We're not looking for the next Wes Anderson. We're looking for you. And I mean, that's sort of the guiding principle with Cine Youth in general, because, you know, sure, you can have a film that looks nice and high production value, but what we want is we want to have a film that communicates essentially your soul. We want to see a film and be like, and know like, ah, like, I understand that filmmaker's worldview. I can see them within the film. Because a film doesn't have to cost a lot of money. It just has to be honest, and it has to show, you know, who you are on screen. Even if you don't even have anything to say, you at least have your own specific worldview. And that's what we're looking for.
100%. And I think something important too is like, and this is myself included, as someone who's just like doing creative things at a like million different directions. Sometimes I think, oh my God, this would be a great idea for me to work on. And then I'll get like overwhelmed of the prospect of making a quote unquote movie and what goes into that. But, you know, the Cine Youth Festival and specifically with like some of the entries, like my friend Ty told me his experience making the film was very entrepreneurial and very independent, and just like he had an idea, wanted to make it, and he did it with what he had and the people he had. Mm-hmm. And sort of like, what's your message to people that are maybe, or younger people and students that are maybe a little bit concerned or kind of scared of the prospect of making a film?
Sure. Well, I guess I would say it doesn't matter what, if you have a film that's shot on an expensive camera with fancy lenses and you rent out all these lights, no matter how much you polish it, it's not going to work unless it like really actually comes from your heart. And, some of my favorite films in CineYouth this year are films that clearly didn't cost very much money at all. They're films that were made with friends or are directly engaging with their family and their family history. And I would just tell people who are afraid to not be into just look inward. And I would especially always encourage young filmmakers to just be weird. That's what I always like to tell people, is everyone has their own personal brand of weird. And that's what we're looking for. We want to see, everyone has their own specific worldview. We want something new. We want all of the, we want you. That's what I would tell people.
It's so funny the way you worded that is exactly how I have been. My business partner and I for this publication, The Known, is exactly how we're framing people coming in. We say, like, we want these perspectives, like the way you think about things. If you can think of, oh, that'd be cool if maybe I took this thing and put it here. It's like, if that's weird to you, write about it, make it, do it, put it into the world, And that's just how I've gotten a lot of like sort of my creative endeavors accomplished. Of like, when I was a child, I really wanted to be a film critic. I would binge Siskel, Ebert, Roper, and all of that. And I eventually just sort of found my way into it. I was like, I like to ask really detailed questions, and I found my niche for that. And I think with film as well, that's a similar sort of route that you can take of embracing that individualistic weirdness.
Absolutely.
And something else I wanted to touch on too is we're both DePaul graduates, and one of the films being shown is directed by Tai Yamamoto, who's a really good friend of mine. And I know that he's like had this film. He hasn't told me any details or anything like that until like it officially got announced that it was showing at CineYouth. But I'm so excited to see something that my friend has made, because I don't know Tai Yamamoto, the filmmaker. I know Tai Yamamoto, the person, the Radio DePaul general manager, mm-hmm. and all these other positions he's held. But, I don't know him from this very personable, like, artistic lens. And I think that that's always really interesting to sort of look at personal projects like that. And what's your sort of reaction of seeing films come out of DePaul, of feeling that there's a bit of a connection there? We came from this sort of same place. Is there like a coolness that sort of comes with that?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, and I always, I'm never surprised, I guess I could even say too, when I encounter certain DePaul films and then I later find out that they, I find out who their instructors were, and I go, oh, of course, I could see how they were, it was sort of they came from this hive, because certain instructors are really great at encouraging people to follow certain paths. And I mean, especially with Ty's film is like incredibly provocative, and it's incredible. I was stunned when I saw it, and it didn't surprise me when I found out that we had shared some instructors. I'm like, oh, of course, like those are the instructors that like lean a little more experimental. So it's like, I'm so glad Ty was able to find them so he would have the courage to make something like this. Unless it was, and of course he could have made it completely independently, but I guess in terms of like hearing about filmmakers coming from DePaul, there is of course some pride there as well.
I love that shared collective influence of, oh, you had that professor? Yeah, I did too. Because mm-hmm. I had that moment with the professor that I brought up earlier, his name being Peter Forrester, of like him really pulling me aside because I was so engaged with the way that he taught and talked about things and was so passionate. And he kind of instilled that into me of like, do this, continue mm-hmm. doing this thing. And it's like that feeling and sharing that with other people and sort of seeing that influence manifest itself is just the coolest thing ever. and especially something palpable like films, of like you worked on it, you are watching it, you're hearing it, you're seeing it, everything. It's a really insane experience. I'm just so happy for Ty, honestly. Like, I'm really overjoyed for him, and I'm super excited to check out this film.
Great. Yeah.
Yeah.